Send your Holy Spirit upon them to be their helper and guide.
Can you help a bit?
Yeah.
Okay.
These are the baptism, not baptism, confirmation. It's, actually, it's 94 of them, yeah, for tonight. All those who are wearing the white shirt. Wearing the white shirt. Yeah. Boys at the back. Ninety-four actually quite well. These are the Thank you.
Jesus.
Thank you.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, welcome to this evening's Eucharist, where we are privileged to pray for 93 of our young adults who will receive the Sacrament of Confirmation. We pray for the Holy Spirit to strengthen each one of them in their faith, so that they will be credible witnesses of Christ in the world today. 各位教友，我们有九十三位我们的年轻人要领见证，我们为他们祈祷，求圣神坚强他们的信德。 So as we come together as one family in faith, let us also acknowledge our need of forgiveness. For times when we have not been faithful to this God of ours, we turn to Him and to one another and we say, I confess to Almighty God.
Yeah.
O God, who calls the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
互相对谈，在你们心中歌颂赞美主，为一切事要因我们的主耶稣基督的名，时时感谢天主的圣灵。
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the crowd, I am the living bread which has come down from heaven. Anyone who eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I shall give is my flesh for the life of the world. Then the Jews started arguing with one another. How can this man give us his flesh to eat? They said. Jesus replied, I tell you most solemnly, if you do not eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you will not have life in you. Anyone who does eat my flesh and drink my blood has eaten the life, and I shall raise him up on the last day. For my flesh is real food, and my blood is real drink. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood lives in me, and I live in him. As I, who am sent by the living Father, myself draw life from the Father, so whoever is me will draw life from me. This is the bread came down, come down from the heaven, not like the bread our ancestors ate. They are dead. But anyone who eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When prepared and are ready to receive the fullness of Christian initiation in the Sacrament of Confirmation, each candidate has been well instructed and is accompanied by a sponsor. It is my privilege to present them to you at this time. Calling of candidates, I invite the 93 candidates for confirmation to please stand.
Please be seated. My dear brothers and sisters, I'm sure you are familiar with the phrase, you are what you eat. Yes? And today we are also self and health conscious. Generally, when I look around, as I see, parishioners are very fit, very healthy. We know what we put into our bodies will become part of us. The late Cardinal Sauter, during the durian season in College General Seminary, he's very disciplined. He watches what he eats most of the time. And there's no one to look. When there's people looking after him, he will be very disciplined. But he told us once or many a time, I don't waste my calories on lousy durians. I eat the good ones and make sure that they are the best. So, and he knows his limit. If we are healthy, whatever we eat, there's no issue on the body if it's in moderation. But if we are unhealthy, we have to take care of what we put into our bodies. The limit, we can't eat as much as we like, we can't eat everything that we like because it affects us if we are not healthy. And we go to lengths to make sure that we keep ourselves healthy so that we can have a meaningful life. It's not just the years, it's not just how long I live, but the quality of my life. And I think we all know that. We eat the body and blood of Jesus. We are what we eat. But why sometimes we are so different from God? Even when we consume Him every day, every week, we find ourselves sometimes so far away from God. Perhaps we have not prepared ourselves to transform ourselves to Him. Perhaps we do not entirely believe it is Jesus we are consuming. Perhaps we lack faith. Or perhaps we follow the desires of the body, and we forget the spiritual side of us. Today we are reminded that the readings were not chosen. It was the actual reading of this 20th Sunday Ordinary Time, and yet it is so appropriate. It speaks about consuming wine, consuming food. Let us consume the Holy Spirit. Let us allow God to permeate into our bodies and be conscious of what we are consuming. Not just physical, normal daily food that you are so particular about, but the food that comes down from heaven, the food that will last forever, the body and blood of Jesus. And the more we are conscious and prepare ourselves to receive God Himself, then we consciously transform and transfigure ourselves to Him. My dear candidates for confirmation, today you will receive the seal of the Holy Spirit on your forehead, a reminder that we all belong to God. You have been branded, so to speak, with God's sign. You belong to Him. Do not allow yourselves to be lost. God never loses any one of His children. If we get lost, it is because we have chosen to move away from God. But God always waits. He always comes after us, through family members, through friends, through circumstances in our lives. We may find ourselves at the crossroads. How do I decide? What do I decide? God is always there for you, with you. Never forget that fact. He is within us. He is around us. He is us. He has become part of us. When we consciously receive His body and His blood, eating His flesh, it becomes our flesh. Drinking His blood becomes part of our own life. And as Jesus gives life to each one of us, may we be life-giving to one another. And may the Holy Spirit strengthen each one of us, and especially our confirmants today. And may we all transform ourselves more and more after the image, after the person of Jesus, who gave His very life on the cross so that we may have life. I invite Father Lawrence to summarize in Mandarin.
主教在那道理当中提到，我们透过食物可以使到我们的健康，我们所吃的成为我们身体的一部分。很多时候，我们领了基督圣体圣血之后呢，我们似乎与天主的距离越来越遥远，我们感觉不到它，我们需要清楚的知道，我们所领受的是天使的食粮，是天上的食粮。 是耶稣基督的身体和圣血。那各位即将要领受见证的亲人们，你们将要领受天主的印记。主教等一下会在你们的头上画上这个印记，不要让自己远离天主。很多时候是我们自己离开了天主，天主一次都在，他透过我们身边的人。 透过我们的老师，透过我们的亲朋好友，不断地给予我们帮助。所以，当我们领受耶稣圣体圣血的时候呢，耶稣圣体圣血就成为了我们的身体的一部分。愿天主圣神不断地引领你们，在你们未来的道路当中，没有离开你们，反而给你们更多的恩宠与力量，让你们能够在未来的生活。 为天主做见证，阿门。Renewal
of baptismal promises. Candidates, please stand.
Satan and all his works and empty promises.
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who came upon the apostles at Pentecost, and today is given to you sacramentally in confirmation?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
Congregation, please stand and respond with the great commandments. This is our faith, this is the faith of the Church, and we are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
My dear friends, in baptism, God our Father gave the new birth of eternal life to his chosen sons and daughters. Let us pray to our Father that he will pour out the Holy Spirit to strengthen his sons and daughters with his gifts and anoint them to be more like Christ, the Son of God.
Can you please sing?
All-powerful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water and the Holy Spirit, you freed your sons and daughters from sin and gave them new life. Send your Holy Spirit upon them to be their helper and guide. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of right judgment and courage, the spirit of knowledge and reverence. Fill them with the spirit of wonder and awe in your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The anointing
with
chrism.
Thank you.
Thank you.
as we rejoice in the Lordship of Jesus Christ and in the presence of His Holy Spirit, let us turn to God our Father for all our needs.
Let us pray for the Church, that all who follow Jesus will truly come to live in the unity of the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Let us pray for all those who are suffering in schools, our families, our community, and the world, for their comfort and assistance from heart and hands, stirred by the Holy Spirit to bring them Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
请为我们的主教、神父、药理老师、父母、代父母、祖父、祖母，以及所有协助我们在信仰生活上成长的人员祈祷。求主增强他们的精神力量，圣德猛进，使他们充满传教的热忱，妥善牧养上主的羊群。
Let us pray for ourselves and all who are praying with us in this beautiful sacramental celebration today, that our hearts might always be places where the gifts of the Holy Spirit will grow, and that these gifts might bear abundant fruits in our lives as disciples of the Lord Jesus, to build up His body in this life and lead one another in love in the next. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayers. 请为圣召祈祷，求主启示青年们积极回应你的召叫，勇敢追随基督的召唤，从事服务人群、造福社会的工作。我们同声祈祷。
We also pray for the upcoming regional pastoral assembly in Majo di Johor. We pray for all the representatives from the Penang, KL, and Majo dioceses, that we will come and discern the voice of the Spirit so as to chart the future of our diocese in Malaysia. We pray to the Lord.